Dear students, welcome to the today's chemistry class. So in the last class we discussed definition of chemistry and importance of chemistry. So let us discuss. So now some basic concepts of chemistry. So this is the first chapter in first PUC chemistry part 1 textbook. So in chemistry we have two parts. Chemistry part 1 NCERT. Chemistry part 2 NCERT. So in the first part of chemistry textbook we have first chapter, some basic concepts of chemistry. So in this chapter yesterday, so in the last class we discussed definition of chemistry and importance of chemistry. So let us discuss now nature of matter. Nature of matter. So matter is nothing but anything which has mass and occupies space. So this matter is nothing but anything in the universe. Anything in the universe which has mass and occupies space is called as matter. So anything which has mass and occupies space is called matter. So here, whatever the things or substances that comes to your mind, whatever the substances they are present around us, they are all considered as matter, because in the universe anything so which has some mass and occupies some volume or space is considered as a matter. Example, say take piece of chalk, say take pen. Say take pencil, say take desk, etc. Book, paper, etc. So totally anything in the universe which has mass and occupies some space is called as matter. Next, states. States of matter. The matter that exists in the universe or in the nature is mainly exist in three states. So this matter has three states in its physical state. So it is first one, solids. Second one, liquids. And third one, gas. Matter in the nature is mainly exist in three states, three physical states: solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. In addition to these three main physical states, matter can also exist in fourth state, that is called as supercooled liquids. Supercooled liquid, and fifth one is Bose Einstein condensate. So fourth state of matter is supercooled liquid. It is called as a plasma state. And fifth one is Bose Einstein condensate. Fourth and fifth state of matter comes under liquids only. So that is why we are considering only three main physical states of matter: solids, liquids, and gases. So here, if you consider first state of matter, that is solids, they have solids have definite shape and volume. If you consider any solid state in the nature, so they have definite shape and volume. And in solids, constituent particles are held together by strong attractive forces. Attractive forces. So in solids, particles are held together by strong attractive forces. That means in solids, the particles are closely arranged in a hard arrangement. Particles are very close to each other. So in these solids, hence there is no much freedom of movement in the solids. Particles do not have much freedom of movement. Only particles in their main positions, so they can vibrate. In the case of solids, particles in the solids do not have much freedom of movement, but they can vibrate in their main positions. And in the case of solid, in the case of liquids, liquid state is the second physical state of matter. And here, particles are close to each other, but they can move around. Liquid state alo kuda particles close age irtave, but avu kelu mattige eno so movement aagtave, they can move around, so move aagtave. So but solid state alli enagutte, there is no much freedom of movement of particles. They can only vibrate in their main positions. Elli irthavo allende vibrate aagta irtave particles solid state alli. But liquid state alli particles swalpa dura move aagtave, but particles are close to each other. Particles liquid state alli kuda close age irtave, aadru kuda avu swalpa mattige eno swalpa dura move aagtave. And once again, liquids have definite volume, but they do not have a definite shape. Liquids have a definite volume, but not definite shape. ಡೆಫಿನೈಟ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ಸ್ ನ ಮೆಷರ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದೇ ಹೊರತು ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ಸ್ ಇದೇ ಶೇಪ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ. ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಶೇಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕಂಟೈನರ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಡ್. ಆ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಯಾವ ಕಂಟೈನರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀವೋ ಆ ಕಂಟೈನರ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಆ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಡೆಫಿನೈಟ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್, ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೈಟ್ ಶೇಪ್. Liquids can take the shape of the container in which it is placed. ಇರಲ್ಲ ಆದರೆ ಯಾವ ಕಂಟೈನರಲ್ಲಿ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ಸ್ನ ಇಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀವೋ ಆ ಕಂಟೈನರ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಶೇಪ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅದೇ ಶೇಪು ಆ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡು ಆಕ್ಯುಪೈ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಟೇಕ್ ಅ ಬೀಕರ್ ಆ ಬೀಕರ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟರ್ ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಬೀಕರ್ ಯಾವ ಶೇಪ್ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅದೇ ಶೇಪು ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದೇ ಹೊರತು ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ಸ್ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಡೆಫಿನೈಟ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು ದಿ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ neither have a definite shape nor definite volume gaseous state anta tagondaga gases anta tagondaga gases ge definite shape kuda iralla definite volume kuda iralla They neither have gases, neither have a definite shape nor definite volume. Because in the gaseous state, particles are loosely arranged. They can move anywhere because the intermolecular force of attractions between the gas molecules is negligible. Intermolecular space is maximum. So it is because in the case of gaseous state, particles are far apart. So they are far apart. They can move anywhere. No intermolecular force of attraction. Intermolecular force of attraction is negligible. Intermolecular space is maximum between the gaseous particles. So these are the three states of matter. So matter in the nature is mainly exist in three states. So that is solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. Once again, depending on the change in the conditions of temperature and pressure. So pressure matte temperature conditions na change maartta idre three states of matter are interconvertible in the nature. Solid state na liquid aagi convert maadabodu. So liquid state na gaseous state aagi convert maadabodu. Similarly vice versa. Gaseous state is converted into liquids. Liquids are converted into the solids. Depending on the change in the conditions of temperature and pressure. So that is solids. Solids on heating. Solids na heat madadaga liquids are formed. Liquids on further heating. Gases are formed. Gases on cooling. On cooling, liquids are formed. So gases get condensed to the liquids. Liquids on further cooling. So they get freezes into the solids. So that is three states of matter is interconvertible in the nature depending on the conditions of temperature and pressure. Solids on heating converted to liquids. Liquids on heating converted to gases. Gases on cooling converted to liquids. Liquids on cooling freezes to solids. These three states in the nature are interconvertible. Okay, next. Classification of matter. So anything in the universe which has mass and occupies space is called as matter.
So that matter in the nature that exists mainly in three physical states, solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. So that three states of matter in the nature is classified mainly into two types. Matter in the nature is classified mainly into two types. They are mixtures. First type of matter is mixtures, and second type of matter is pure substances. Pure substances. So here, matter is mainly classified into two types: mixtures and pure substances. So mixtures. Mixtures are nothing but particles, two or more particles of pure substances present in any ratio. Mixtures are nothing but two or more particles of pure substances present in any ratio is called as a mixture. Pure substances are nothing but particles of substances are present in a fixed ratio or definite ratio is called the pure substances. Mixtures are nothing but two or more particles of pure substances combined or present in any ratio is called as mixtures. Particles of substances are present in a fixed or definite ratio is called as a pure substances. Further, mixtures are classified into two types. So that is types of mixtures. So we have two types of mixtures. They are homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. Mixtures are two types: homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures are nothing but two or more components are completely mixed with each other, and its composition is uniform throughout. Is called homogeneous mixtures. Two or more components are completely mixed with each other, and its composition is uniform throughout. Is called as a homogeneous mixtures. Example you take for a homogeneous mixture. Air is a mixture of different gases. Air consists of carbon dioxide, oxygen, hydrogen, carbon monoxide, so okay, nitrogen, etc. But all these gases are completely mixed with each other and form a uniform composition throughout.
sodaraka air is a homogeneous mixture of all other different gases. We cannot identify the different gases present in the air by physical methods.
So air is a homogeneous mixture, and sugar plus water, whenever we take sugar and dissolve in the water, it forms a solution.
Then in that solution, homogeneous
uniform composition exists, because sugar is one component, water is another component. Sugar and water components are completely mixed with each other, forming one homogeneous medium, only one medium. And a third one, salt plus water. Salt solution,
whenever we take sodium chloride salt and dissolved in water, it forms salt solution.
Now salt is completely mixed with water to form a uniform composition, to form a homogeneous mixture. So while taking sugar solution, salt solution or air, the components are present in any ratio. Here there is no fixed ratio for the components to form homogeneous mixtures. So you take air, oxygen percentage, say you take 21%, nitrogen is say you take 17%, carbon dioxide you take 0.03% in the air. Means different components are present in different ratios, different percentages. So that is why mixture is nothing but particles of two or more pure substances which may present in any ratio. Illi so mixture formation aagbeku antandre components proportionality percentage onde irbeku anno condition illa. So one component one ratio alli idre, one percentage alli idre, innond component bere percentage alli irbodu. That is called as mixtures. So examples for homogeneous mixtures: air, sugar solution, salt solution, etc. And next, second type of mixtures is heterogeneous. Heterogeneous mixtures. So here hetero is nothing but different. Genius medium. So that means here two or more components which do not completely mix with each other, and its composition is not uniform throughout. The components are visible, they get separated. So it is heterogeneous medium or heterogeneous mixtures are nothing but two or more components cannot mix with each other and its composition is not uniform throughout. So here whenever we try to mix two or more components, then those components always form separate layers. They do not completely mix with each other, so that the composition is not uniform throughout. Always the components what we try to mix, they are always form separate layers. Distinct layers are formed in heterogeneous mixtures. Different layers, different mediums are formed in heterogeneous mixture. Example for heterogeneous mixture. Kerosene plus water, oil plus water. Next, salt plus sugar. Salt plus sugar, pulses plus grains plus rice plus some dirt, etc. These are all examples for the heterogeneous mixtures. So here also the components are not in a fixed ratio. So kerosene present in one proportion, water is present in another proportion. When you try to mix both, the amaze forms of two distinct layers, bere layer agide partition aagutave. So the composition uniform agiralla. So that is why the components of heterogeneous mixtures, one heterogeneous mixture alli ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀವಿ ಅಷ್ಟು ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ನ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೆಟ್ರೋಜಿನಿಯಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸೆಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಸಮ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್. ಏನ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೇ ಟೇಕ್ ರೈಸ್. ಇನ್ ರೈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಪಲ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್, ಗ್ರೈನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್, ಸಮ್ ಡರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. Those dirt, pulses and grains can be separated by hand picking and kerosene oil present in water can be separated by separating funnel is not now. So oil, kerosene, water separate maarbodu. Asala similarly filtration, crystallization, hand picking. So these are the physical methods which can be used to separate the unmixed or distinct layers, different layers of heterogeneous mixtures. ಯಾಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಹೆಟ್ರೋಜಿನಿಯಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಗಿ ಅವು ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತವೆ, ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕಾಂಪೊನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರಲ್ಲ. ಆ ಥರ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಲೇಯರ್ಸ್ನ ನಾವು ಯಾವಾಗ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಿಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್, ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲೈಸೇಷನ್, ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪಿಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ಈ ಥರ ಮೆಥಡ್ಸ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಕಾಂಪೊನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ನ ನಾವು ಹೆಟ್ರೋಜಿನಿಯಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ಸಿಂದ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್.